Warwick Thresh banned away, Gnar banned away, by Curse Academy, so it wasn't a blue side Gnar ban, we just thought it was.
Yeah, and it appears to be just be the same ban every time, and yeah, the Warwick from Fusion every single time, even when they're on blue side.
Lissandra,
so here's the thing, is they
now
get to ban Lissandra because they can first pick the Corki for themselves if Niantonsa was comfortable on that champion.
Left cast, or they banned away Kassadin, so they do leave the Corki.
The thing is, they also hovered that Kassadin first when the Cursed Academy was on the blue side. So banning the Kassadin away, and now, yes, the Corki pick up first round for them because they're blue side. They get to do that and get the Lissandra off the table.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense here. And again, a nice adaptation from Fusion. This is what they were lacking in games 1 and 2, being able to mix it up in picks and bans. Now this time, the Jarvan might go over to Saint Vicious, and he is hovering it right now, so we'll see Nintendude forced onto something else if that does go through, and it is.
That is really high up on his tier list of what junglers are good on this patch, so there's no question about why he's prioritizing that. Also, it's going to force Nintendude onto something else, and we're going to see how deep his champion pool is.
Speaking of forcing, Kopp has been fairly comfortable on a number of things, but obviously the Corki pickup is what they wanted. But they didn't want it before. Nien wanted to mix it up now. It's still a flex pick because they can give it over to Huhi. Ezreal's still on the table. Just like last game, they banned it in the reset. It ended up not being banned after the fact. So we'll see how Kopp does on Lucian this time.
He didn't go for the Sivir, so they're not going for another movement speed composition here. They're kind of going back to their roots and going off of their previous victories and just go with a hard engage composition. And Jarvan is only going to help that more.
There's a lot of top tier support still on the board. Thresh was the one banned away. Obviously, there's a high number of Janna would be a little bit anti-synergy if you want the chase. I mean, you can use Janna for the chase down as well if you can like get a flash monsoon off, but ooh, look at that one. They're going to lock in both the Zed and the Rumble. Macnoon and Huhi over on the side of Curse Academy, debating their next moves here. And you know, they did telegraphed a little bit, but Curse Academy, they don't seem to really mind if they telegraph their moves to the enemy team because they're just confident that they're able to beat you down anyways.
Yeah, they have really deep champion pools across the board. Keen pretty much plays everything and everything you don't think is good too. He pretty much practices
he makes it
all
look good.
Day. Yeah, he will just go home.
This would be a situation where he could pull out the Hecarim because he has done it against Zed before extremely well. I think they're debating it right now.
Oh, here's the thing, is that the Hecarim mid...
He got it.
So, the Hecarim mid beats all AD melee mids. So it crushes Yasuo, and it does well against Zed. Because in order for them to do damage to you, they have to be close to you. So your Spirit of Dread and also your Rampage, they have to be close to you to deal damage to you. You're crushing them with your damage. Your Rampage cooldown only goes down after you hit it once. So that's what they're looking for here. And that goes in to their hard engage composition to get on Niantonso.
And so does the Maokai here for Haunser, so that works really, really well. They have a lot of single target and multiple target lockup, not necessarily AoE, but that soft form of CC where you're either slowed or you just can't move anywhere because you're stuck. So on the other side, they need some disengage for Fusion. Gleep Glarbu is going to immediately lock in the Janna. This makes a lot of sense, as it could have been given away anyway. So what are they answer with a Curse Academy here? And look at that, Nintendo going back to the Spider.
That's what he's got. That's really what he's got, is Jarvan and Elisa, the two champions we've seen from him, and that's it. He played Kha'Zix one game, but that was 419. On this patch, 420, we've only seen Elise and Jarvan from him.
Yeah, over for the last pick here, Curse Academy, Bunny Fufu contemplating the move that they want to make to secure up this composition. What will help them? I feel like a Leona might actually be a really good thing here.
Bunny Fufu could play something like Morgana, try to land a binding. You could get something like a Leona. He doesn't play it that much.
It's an all-in thing. I think the Morgana makes a little more sense just because of the comfortable pickup.
Another thing, too, is that it helps you engage with the binding. It slows people when you just flash in onto them, and the Black Shield will stop it so that you can't disengage that guy who just went in to that team. So if Haunser's running at you with Righteous Glory, you can't peel him.
Also, they don't really need the tank stats provided by Leona by comparison, like what you're giving up Morgana to do. So, because they've got Haunser.
Yes.
And they've also got Sayn, who can go very, very tanky on that one. And Keen, he's not going to be incredibly squishy either. So this team is actually very bruiser hefty.
It's all go, go, go
in. It's going to be really difficult for Fusion to wear down that front line because the entire team is the front line.
I just thought about it too. And the fact that Righteous Glory gives you so much movement speed, it's going to add on to Keen's damage when he runs in.
Maybe Bunny should take a coin start too. All the movement speed.
Oh, man. So this is going to be a really fast Hecarim coming through here. One of Keen's signature champions in the mid lane. He's played it so much, and he plays it in certain situations. This is one of the counter picks that he hits you with that you're like, oh, I didn't know that was a counter pick.
Yeah, the last time he played Hecarim in this tournament, he went 8-3-11, I believe.
Yeah.
It's not exactly a score to sneeze at. So Fusion, they realize what they're up against here. This is all the cards on the table loading up here. St. Vicious relaxing before the match, but this is going to be a pretty epic game. If it is the final game, it's going to be crazy. But if it's not, we still got a game 5 to go. We'll see what happens. We want to know what you guys think, though. Go ahead and tweet us at LOL Esports using the hashtag LCS Expansion for all your predictions and prophecies.
And this composition that they've made for themselves on Curse Academy's side is just all forward motion, all go, all get in. But this time, it's not running at them from everybody, because Keen will flank around with Hecarim and be very, very fast coming into the fight. But then they have a lot of people who have gap closers. They have somebody who can help pick with Morgana. There's a lot of options here to start the fight and to get to Nian Tanso. He eats a binding. He's going to get flag and dragged on and then just destroyed.
Here he comes out the gates, Keen, and charging
off
his way. And yeah, actually, St. Fish is keeping up with him on two legs, actually. That's a pretty good job. Here we go, starting this one off. I don't expect too many shenanigans this time. The lane swaps have been pretty prevalent with this Fusion team, but it's not looking like it's going to happen this time around. Line of scrimmage starts. Again, when everything is on the line, you don't want to make any early mistakes. Fusion not going to go for the shenanigans.
And the thing with Fusion's composition... Ooh,
face check. We'll talk about it in a minute, because Gleeb Glarbu running straight into Keen and Bunny.
It's a lot of damage from Keen.
They do have a ton. They might finish him off, forcing a flash, and he also burns through
Bunny
a couple
almost
biscuits.
Has binding again.
They could. Oh,
ooh.
He's not going to get him, but that was close. And he has to back now. That's big start for Curse Academy.
Exactly, forcing the flash. And you saw that early game damage from Keen there. The fact that that Rampage only goes on a lower cooldown every time you use it and hit something with it means that you're eventually just flag twirling on top of the person and just beating them up.
Yeah, Keen kind of can just style on people's faces once he gets to that point, and Gleeb just couldn't run away fast enough. They needed Huhi to step in and help. And not only that, just a little small mental victory there for Curse Academy, saying, oh, you beat us in that last game? Well, here's what we can do to you level one if you just make a tiny mistake.
Yeah, and the Morgana's a big part of that. But Gleeb also blowing his flash that early in the game is pretty big. I don't know how much Saints can be able to capitalize on it because of the jungle changes and the fact that he won't be too active until then, but we'll see.
Yeah, and actually it's Curse Academy instigating this lane swap right now. They send Cop and Bunny to the top and going to have a little bit of a jungle buddy system here with Hanser and Saint, but they're taking their time about it. He's actually going ahead and start the Raptor, so they're going to split up the way they do it to start this game off.
Yep, and it's going to be Hanser once again, like you said, doing the Raptors, getting himself that level 2. Cop trying to freeze the wave so that they all smack that one minion. And then Mac Noon goes to the jungle, and I like this start here, but once again, Curse Academy, they didn't force this lane swap. Or sorry, they forced this lane swap. Fusion didn't, even though they were the ones who had done it before.
Well, they started to get a little more comfortable in the AD carry role, but just when you think it is, they're mixing it up. And speaking of mixing it up, here comes Bunny Fufu. Tendude's going to smite that one down. It's perfectly okay, but Hanser now
Hanser's
is
here.
Joining the fray. And St. Vicious isn't far behind.
He's
they blocked
two.
The Magnoon. He's pretty low. Ignites on him. They're trying to burn him down. And the flash forward, the binding, they might have it. An auto attack would do it, and it is first blood over to Bunny Fufu.
The Morgana play from Bunny Fufu. This is one of those champions that if he can't get Thresh and somebody counterpicks it away from him, he will pick that into you. But he's very comfortable on that champion right underneath his Thresh.
Yeah, he's played quite a lot of Morgana in this tournament
as
well. Definitely no stranger to it, especially on this patch. He gets himself a nice little extra bit of gold to make this game a little bit smoother for him. But again, there's really no resistance in this top lane. Mac Noon, he had to go back after all that. Or rather, he had to go back to Fountain. And
his Tended
was a little bit reset as well. So he's down clearing his jungle out, clearing that red. But how can he really get involved in this? We mentioned last time Nintendo played Elise, was forced to play Elise. He didn't really ever ramp up here, and Curse Academy knows this. They've seen that bot.
Yeah, like his scoreline was good. He was 1-2-7 as a jungler, but at the same time, you need more impact in the later game because he got a lot of those assists early on, and then he wasn't able to do too much later.
Yeah, and it's definitely not his preference right now. He was obviously an Elise player for a while. I think he played it a lot before even it was really considered high meta, but now it's kind of been a little bit out there. And see, you just can't roam on this guy. He just speeds himself up. Nintendo wasn't even there. Glebe was showing face early.
Sorry.
Now, Fusion might go for this.
His stat line on Elise was 6-1 and 16. Is very impressive.
Oh, that actually is very
good.
But
that's the thing, is that's the game that they lost when they were down, where they were up 10,000 gold.
That's right. But again, that's the late game. It was also the fact that Final Five was able to make some big moves happen and sneak objectives. Speaking of sneaking, Fusion this time is trying this three-man dragon, juggling the aggro quite well here. Dragon just doesn't know who he wants to attack.
Just knocked Sweeps. Everybody back. Yeah, he's sick
angry.
Of it. I can't hit anybody.
Shouts at Nintendo, though.
Yep.
Fusroda.
And backing it up. Everybody just going back and forth, juggling that dragon as much as possible. And it looks like it's going to be first dragon to Fusion, 4 minutes into the game, pulling one on Curse Academy.
I really got to hand it to them. This entire series, just in general, they've been able to secure up more dragons, especially than they were able to against Final Five. They didn't even consider that to be something that they wanted to really fight over, and they just let Final Five have so many of them. This time, it's been a completely different game. And now look at this. Actually, Saint and Cop are going to be taking a couple of shots at this tower. They don't want to fast push it too quickly, but they send a lot of members up here to try and zone MacNoon away and shut him
binding.
Down. And they found the binding.
He's
on him.
Flash.
Black and drag in. He can't really get out of this one. Just trying to walk it out. Can his suit take the damage? I don't think so. It's Hanser picking him up. And MacNoon 0-2 on this game.
They knew he didn't have his flash from the previous encounter where they killed him. And another binding from Bunny Fufu to get them that kill in the early game.
Yeah, continuing to have this top lane unabated, a teleport now having to be used. MacNoon's just having a rough time here, and that has really been the way that they found the win conditions, but now, gotta be careful, you can't dive too far. Hanser taking a little bit of damage from MacNoon in the tower. Cop is by himself here since everyone's backing away, but every other lane, Curse Academy doing quite well, and this one also.
Yeah, and they're not going to allow MacNoon, this is part of the lane swap too, to be up against Hanser in that top lane. So MacNoon, part of the strategy is to keep him down.
Nintendo,
look at that.
Yeah, look at that burst damage. He has to rappel up, and he actually may not get away from this one. Ignite is taking his health bar down. Oh, and he gets him with the W.
It's Ignite.
Yep, that does actually get picked. Yeah, he gets the credit over to Bunny, so even more gold for him.
Bunny is just racking up the kills. 2-0-1. 6 minutes in the game. It's a support streak.
Bunny carry, man.
When's he going to get that Zonya's Hourglass?
Eventually.
10 minutes.
He's super useful for those mid-game team fights. Now, they have to deal with Nianton, so he's been getting a free farm for far too long down in this bottom lane, perfectly happy to take it. Another binding is going to land. Bunny, he's not just a one-hook pony. He's got the bindings, too.
Yeah, but there's another pony in this game. Speaking Bam, of, dude, they were on that one.
They got it this time.
The observers know me too well. Let's let that segue. But Keen in this mid lane, he's been having a good time. You can see that. He already got home guard on his boots, so he can just keep running back to this lane, clearing it out on the Zed.
Ui has not had too much trouble getting a little bit of farm back here, but he just can't deal with Keen. And the speed boost is incredible. The first item he completes is the Ninja Tabby with home guards.
Yeah.
There's no catching this guy.
That's his standard on this. Like I said, he plays it into AD melee mids, and the fact that he gets those boots just it magnifies the effect of Hecarim mid.
It's almost like he's never gone, even when he backs.
Because basically, the thing too is that gives him armor, gives him stats to deal with the AD mid, but it also gives him damage because of his passive. So that's actually an offensive buy.
Yeah. One more thing, and he's started to ramp up pretty effectively versus who he had. Look at how fast he is. Zoom, zoom, zoom. Take a break.
There he goes.
You need another carrot for Eponia.
So he just was just there, and now he's back. And he's farming again.
Yeah, like I said, he was never gone, really. And now they re-swap back here. Curse Academy going to send Cop and Bunny Fufu down to the bottom to try and see if they can get a little bit more dragon control. When the dragon does come back up, Sneaky One was taken by Fusion, of course. But Curse Academy still ahead about 1,000 in the gold game.
Ooh.
And everybody's having a little bit of a rough time on this Fusion
he
side.
He just got a ton of consumables on his back.
Oh, he did.
He got himself a crystalline flask, too.
Yeah, that'll help us sustain out. Not necessarily the battle stats, but I mean, he could have gone in all in on him, but he just hasn't really had the opening for it, and he hasn't even been able to finish his bilge water just yet, so he is a little bit starved now. Keen's able to clear the wave away, push him back continuously. It's going to lean heavily on the end and Glebe for this early game, because they've really been the only ones who have had an easy go of it, and they haven't really had a lane opponent for the last 5 minutes.
Yeah, exactly, because of the lane swap. And man, Bunny Fufu, though, he's been doing really well for himself.
2-0-1 is not a bad tagline
he's
for
roaming
your sport.
Around. Roaming around.
Oh, look at him. He's got those shoes on, too. He's not the only one. Let's see if he can catch who he here. It'll be difficult to
use his W.
Bind on the ninja, yeah. But St. Vicious is up top. They're trying to set up multiple traps at once. Everyone knows on Fusion side that Cop and Bunny are not quite at home. Oh, They're going to land the Cocoon. Saint might have gone a little bit too far forward. MacNoon, the Repel up for Nintendo. Hanser is going to Twisted Advance to stop it. And Face Tank, they have the way to bail out, but he's starting to burn. Trees are apparently weak to fire.
Apparently.
Here comes King.
I just learned that today. Thank you for that.
You're welcome.
Never knew that. Oh, the bottom lane, they finally swapped it back, though. That's the big part of it, is that the lane swap is no longer going on. They're just bashing each other's heads in now. And it's Nian Tansa with the CS advantage.
Absolutely, and that's been a big result of him not ever having to really lead this lane, not ever really getting challenged. So that's the edge that Fusion have right now. They need to push it. Again, they seem to do well when their shot caller is having an easy time of it, so that might be yet a boon for them. 58 seconds on this dragon coming up, but Curse Academy are not making this bottom side or this mid side look very easy.
In this mid lane, I really want to just see what Keen ends up doing. He's backing again.
He'll be back.
And here's the thing too, is there's actually a synergy between Homeguard Boots and Crystalline Flask, because after you use all of the charges, you just go back and you're instantly back to lane very, very quickly.
Yeah, he's just got so much sustain off that as well, and it's so hard to catch him. So Bui is really starting to have a rough time here, but he's been keeping up decently in CS. He just can't really check too far forward, and any gank attempts on Keen is pretty futile. He just can't catch the guy.
He's just popping more of his Crystalline Flask. He pops all of the charges just to get his mana back up, and he's going to clear another wave. So I really like the pressure, because he's keeping Huhi in this lane, stopping him from roaming, and dealing with that. Man, just the edge of that binding. They still lose the turret, though, because the amount of pressure that Nian Tansa is able to apply here because of the little bit of an advantage he has.
Yeah, now it looks like it might be a party at the Dragon Pit. It is live. Nintendo wants to set up for this one. Saint Vicious, a little bit preoccupied clearing the crowd. We haven't seen much of him since he last visited that top lane, but they will leave those two guys alone for now. Teleports both available.
And here's the thing, too, is it's not just that Nian Tansa is ahead. It's also the fact that they have that first Dragon buff. So you take Nian Tansa's inventory, and you basically add a longsword to it.
Help him work his way towards another item. Definitely starting to look for a little bit more here. They want to back and take this tower and then be able to secure that dragon up, but see if people are getting back. Keen was away for a little bit longer than usual this time, and that wave is going to be depleted, but they've done some serious damage to the tower, what Huhi was not able to accomplish on his own.
Had that tiny little window, and they took advantage of it with that roam. Lucian head back. They got the bottom turret. Lucian started coming into lane. Cop very late, showing up middle finally, and now he's just sharing experience. And now Keen runs to the bottom lane to get the rest.
You gotta run to get that farm, man. He's gonna be able to clean that up quite well, quite nice. And then, of course, up in the top, these guys, they could bash each other. We've seen the Rumble and Maokai match up quite frequently. It's not something that's really unusual by any means, but it's all gonna be about when they teleport in, what's going to be the impetus for it. This dragon is pretty sighted up right now, and they need to be able to secure, either side needs to be able to secure an advantage before they can safely even attempt to take it, because it's ended in disaster one too many times.
And we got some Sightstone junglers on the field now, just trying to ward up and get their team the vision that they need. And Keen, he's on the roaming hacker. When I first heard about Keen, I heard that his roam timings are the best thing about him from Atlas. And now, see if it meets. It makes sense. He's
pops
the ghost.
MacNoon, he's trying to cut him off. Whoa, nice flash timing from MacNoon, but he's coming right back in. MacNoon scared, but he won't take that much damage now. This is going to prompt Fusion to start off that dragon, realizing Keen is away. Fusion will play, and this dragon is going down pretty quickly right now. No capitalization available from Curse Academy.
Second dragon of the game here. MacNoon just clearing out the minion wave with his ultimate, making sure that they can't dive him, that they can't get to him, because his flash is down. They just popped it, and now here comes Keen. They thought he was top.
Well, he was top. Not anymore, though. Teleport's now coming in. Double teleports. Hanser and MacNoon. This will be the fight over the blue buff. Huhi going forward. Hanser, Huhi's actually going to take down St. Vicious. He will die for that one. It's a one-for-one trade so far. That blue was just angry right in the middle of it all. Here comes Keen, though, charging out. Soul Shackles only on Gleave Glarbu. Trying to get away. He burns his Flash Bunny a little far forward. They get the lock up on MacNoon, trying to disengage this one, but they're so low.
A
big one, and he just shreds down. So much armor. Another big one. Hanser's in trouble. They're going to turn to chase on him. Can he get the double? Yes, he can. Nian Tansa 2-0.
That fight just trailed off all the members of Fusion in attendance. Keen came in a little later, but he didn't have his ultimate, and MacNew didn't have his either. It was kind of this team fight that wasn't as explosive as it could have been, and it trailed off, and they just overextended and chased too far from Curse Academy's side.
And those dragon stats, at least the first dragon, definitely helping out a little bit more with this one. So tower will fall down now. They're able to peck away at it. Two towers to none. Fusion definitely looking strong. If they can win this game, they'll be one more game closer. Here we go in the replay.
Yeah, Huhi uses ultimate to pick off St. Vicious, but then Keen is off on the side and actually gets him as soon as it comes down. And then they start chasing here. They go way too far. Dian Tonso just looks like a very juicy target. Keen starts going after it. But then the disengaged tornado and the turnaround here.
It's incredibly impressive the way they were able to bait and switch that, really. And in the end, just moving over the wall. And he grabs Haunter after the fact. Gleaves helping him out with that one.
And the perfect.
Nicely played there. So 3-4 is the scoreline right now. But it is Fusion that find themselves in a slight gold lead. They have two dragons to nil. And they have two turrets to nil as well. Going to roam around this map and just keep grabbing themselves those little edges that turn into big ones.
Curse Academy don't have any dragons in their favor just yet. They need to start working on that part of the map, because if you look at the entire map just from Fusion in terms of vision, they have almost the entire river warded up. And then you look at Curse Academy's, it's not even close.
Well, they haven't had to really fight over these dragons either. They've been sneaky. They've been realizing, hey, you know, Keen's up top, or hey, St. Vicious just showed himself in the topside jungle. We can do this right now, and their timing windows have just become so much better. Fusion has really adapted as a team on the fly, far better than I think a lot of people realize.
Yeah, I love the fact that they started picking the Corki first, taking away from Cop, and then getting Cop on something he like not his top-tier champion, not the top-tier champion on 4.20, right? Getting him on these things that are kind of secondary and forcing Bunny Fufu onto something else too. Like banning away the Thresh and then force picking the Corki. Really, really, really like that strategy from Fusion, just to mix it up and make Curse Academy adjust to them.
Yeah, Curse Academy, they have been trying to grab a little bit back, and they did pretty well in the kills, but they just haven't really been able to capitalize on that. And it seems like those roles have switched, where they're just not the ones grabbing objectives this time. Fusion has changed their primary motivation for these games here. And Tonso just trying to send a couple of rockets out Bunny's way, but he's able to clear the ward away nonetheless. Pretty close to even on gold. It's still 1,000 gold lead for Fusion here in this game. Huhi now looking to chase out Keen. That guy may have been all over the map, but he just still doesn't have the damage he needs.
Yeah, he doesn't have the damage, and he's been trying to roam. He almost has his Trinity Force, but that's a really big item spike for Hecarim. And then basically everything that Hecarim gets is a really big item spike. It's like Spear Visage, got it. He's like, oh, I got my boots, big item spike.
Everything is big for the pony, but he's got to come up with more than just that one kill if his team wants to keep on going forward. They only need one win here, Curse Academy, to make it into the LCS. But if they're down, we saw what happened the last time Fusion started out a series 0-2.
Yeah. Is it going to be the same story? Are they going to come back against Curse Academy? Or is Curse Academy going to do what they did to Coast, 3-1?
Either one of them is very possible right now. Keen and Huhi, 1v1 in this bottom side. But the top tower is the focus right now for Fusion, but they're the ones who are sieging this down. In Curse Academy, they have to play the reaction game. They're not able to move where they want to on this map. Fusion just making sure nowhere is safe, even in your own jungle. Curse Academy have some trouble. Here comes Keen out the gates, charging.
He just backs for the pieces of the Trinity Force, of the Zeal.
It doesn't really cost him much time.
Yeah. Get back to lane, and this Hecarim is something that I've seen him play before, and it was always kind of hit or miss, but it usually ended up missing in the late game because he goes really hard. But this team composition that he has, if Haunter can get his Rod of Ages, he's not going to go for the Righteous Glory this time apparently, and St. Vicious, and they can all just pile on the back line, get to Nian Tonso, make sure that Huhi doesn't have a good target to blow up, then Curse Academy has the team fight they want. Whereas Fusion, they can throw down the ultimate from MacNoon, they can poke, they can disengage, they have a lot of options here, and then they can all in or split push with Huhi.
Yeah, they have a lot of ways they can make this work, but in particular, it seems like they're just so much more comfortable, even though some of them had to deal with some early game strife here. MacNoon actually starting the game 0-2 just by being effectively camped for a little bit, being roamed on. He's been able to come back quite well.
Ahead in CS in that top lane. The Rod of Ages finally completed onto Haunzer. 18 minutes into the game.
Skullcrab going down.
Dragon is live, so they are going to have this vision on it on Fusion's side. This would be their third dragon of the game if they're able to pick it up for themselves.
Again, this is all what they've been about, just turning these victories, little ones into big ones, but who? He could be in trouble now. Teleport, double teleport coming in on a pair of minions. Magnoon gets there first, throws down the equalizer, doesn't land where he needed it to be, but here is Glaive around the side. They're bringing Bunny to the party. There's no tower to fall back to. Haunzer getting poked down.
They want to go.
Vicious jumping on Tendu. There's the Monsoon. Not going to be enough. Keen's going to take down Magnoon, and that is Haunzer who's staying alive here. A double kill going over to Keen. Nintendo, a triple kill. Can he get the Quadra? He's looking for Glaive Glarbu. He might land even more than that. The binding's not going to go where he wants it. Keen going in. He gets over the wall, staying alive. Tiny bit of health. Bunny's going to take that one, and Keen picks himself up the unofficial Quadra after the fact. That's going to be the first dragon for Curse Academy.
That is a huge turnaround for them. Niantonso had nothing to do with that fight, and they're going to pick up their first dragon of the game, which just gave Keen over 10 damage.
Yeah, let's take a look at that one again. That was crazy.
Yeah, so what happens here is he chases him all the way in, and then Fusion decides we should turn this. Nien cuts to the right on the map. Ultimate whiffs, then they start backing up, but here comes Glaive. Here comes Bunny. Puts the shield down, and they all go in. There's the Cataclysm on top of everybody. Glaive Glarbu throws out the ultimate, but it doesn't actually disengage them. It just pushes them all to group up on top of Magnoon, and that's how they end up taking this fight, was the fact that it wasn't properly disengaged, and the fact that both AD carries were not there. And that's one of the edges that they had coming into this fight, was Niantonso.
Yeah, they effectively took a 4v4 that turned into a really wonky 5v4, but again, Curse Academy coming up absolutely huge on that one. Haunzer, they tried to target him out, but he was way too tanky a tree. And there's a little more spring in the step of the Curse Academy side now.
It was a really good attempt to disengage it from Glaive, though, but the Black Shield did stop Haunzer from getting knocked up and then just completely piled on. But instead, they turned it around and piled on to the team of Fusion with a good knockup from St. Vicious and then all of the follow-up from Haunzer. Really, really thought that fight was played almost immaculately from Curse Academy.
Yeah, and in the aftermath of it all, Keen's able to pick down a tower on the bottom. They answered with Fusion on the top, but here's an interesting point, too. We like to talk about Keen, maybe what he's able to do split push-wise, who he likes to make that same play, but Keen just has this insane mobility. Usually you think about as being able to 1v1 anyone. Well, Keen can 1v1 anyone, but in the rare situation that he can't, he can get out of there so quick. Now, Bunny, he might not be so fortunate, though. Yep, St. Fish is going to get blown out of his own ultimate. The Monsoon is on. Here comes Keen. He's going to jump on in. Where did Glaive Glarbu go? I don't know. The culling is out on Niantonso, and he's down. Cop picking him up on the backside of that one.
You saw Keen on the bottom side of the map, and you were talking about mobility, rushes straight up, clippity-clop, Fusion gonna drop, comes straight into that fight, and makes it and turns it around for them.
Yeah, the Busta Rhymes, you got that on point, man, and now Curse Academy, they have the chance to push in on this top side. Easy objective with no one around to defend it. Keen, he's back to mid. This guy's in every lane at once.
He's also 6-0-2, so he's having a really good game on that Hecarim. It ended up being a really good pick in this composition. I talked about how they love to engage fights on Curse Academy's side, and that's how they're winning these games, is by having hard engage. Engage that you can't get off of you. They get Cataclysm. Keen busts it. He says, go. Hits his E, gets in there, goes over two walls pretty much. He goes over that one and into the Cataclysm. He's like, he doesn't care.
And Magnoon, again, couldn't land his ultimate where he needed to, that equalizer. It's so hard to position that because it depends on being able to land on somebody, but they move out of it.
His equalizers this game have been used on minion waves and through brushes, and they haven't been on point. Magnoon's equalizers are very questionable. And then the team fight happens afterwards, and he's not using it during the team fight. That one he just threw down there was probably the best one he's thrown all game.
Yeah, and you know, he hadn't played a ton of Rumble prior to the tournament. He did play it once, I believe, in this tournament, but it really wasn't necessarily the top pick choice for him. And here we go, Keen gonna get jumping in on Huhi again. Can he get out of this one? I don't think so. Keen is godlike at 23 minutes, 7-0-2 on the pony.
Is Curse Academy going to get into the LCS off the back of Hecarim?
It might very well happen, and it's looking like Fusion are starting to be scattered around here. Objectives starting to be piled on. Nintendo trying to defend away from Keen, but he has really started galloping away with this game. Bunny, Fufu, locked up under tower range. Nintendo getting a little greedy, going for him, trying to back away. I don't think he can go anywhere, though. He can't rappel up, and they just try to jump on him with everything they got, but he's finally going to burn down. St. Vicious hits him in the back of the head.
Gets him with the reach there. Keen and the rest of Curse Academy in this bottom lane. They're missing two of their members. They're about to get flanked by three other members.
They just have to buy a little bit of time. St. Fish is going to jump on Gleep Glarber, who is there for. He just absolutely melted Keen, picking up another one. And Bunny still lives. And here comes Cop. MacNoon's in trouble, trying to run his way out of this one. Electro Harpoon to slow him down. Hoohee going to see if he can pick up an assassination. Going to try to shadow step in, but Hanser is there to zone. Bunny Fufu playing the dangerous game. Pulls out a binding. Hanser has the death mark on him. He finally pops to Dien Tonso, who's leading the charge. Blinking health bars across the board for Curse Academy. And they know they got to get out of here.
And that's usually the time that Dien Tonso, he wants to chase, but he doesn't have the mana to continue to poke them down. So Curse Academy come out on top with a big net gain, and 8-0-1-3 for Hecarim. And I talked about his power spikes. Boots are a power spike. Trinity Force is a huge power spike for him. Also the fact that he has the Brutalizer, Shreds just flat armor, gives him CDR. It's such a great item on him. And it looks like he's going to go for a Spirit Visage next.
And here he goes. He's heading straight to the Baron, but
he needs to get there.
They're already there. They're starting this one up. This is desperation mode right now, though. It is 25 minutes into this game. This is a very early Baron, but Fusion are starting to melt it down. There's no reaction here, and they sneak it through.
It's going to give them that little burst of gold, extra minion stats, little specialties. Here's the thing, Keen backing again. He just got to lane.
They don't have any idea this happened.
He doesn't even care.
Curse Academy have not shown
themselves just yet.
They're about to find out, but yes. Still a lead, but it's a breathing space for Fusion. They have a chance to start pushing, but Keen.
There it is, the Spirit Visage.
Here he comes. Yeah, he is starting to get pretty hard to deal with no matter what. Oh, and a Death Brush here for Curse Academy.
High damage, high mobility, high defensive stats right now from Keen.
This is perfect right now. The dragon has been what Fusion have been making a beeline to. So this time, Curse Academy beat them there. There's the time. Here we come. I don't know if you can get away from this one. MacNoon's going to land the Equalizer, but he's going to go down pretty quickly for it. That's Keen with the legendary kill in the end, trying to bail out the backside. St. Vicious went down to Hui on the back of it. A one-for-one trade. It still looked better for Curse Academy, and they can start to contest this dragon even without the smite.
Yeah, the smite is the big thing here, but I don't think they're going to go for it. They're going to play it a little safer. Keen. Nope. You know what?
He wants some farm.
He wants
man.
Some farm.
Sometimes
horses
just
farms.
Farm.
You know, it makes sense. Goes right for that. A dragon is live. They're just waiting on it. MacNoon. They took him out. They separated him from the fight using Keen's ultimate. Keen's ultimate already half off cooldown.
Yeah, they really just have such low timers on this one. Curse Academy is able to refresh consistently.
And he's gonna have Ghost for the next engage. So Dien Tonso getting away is virtually impossible.
They can do the chase down. You mentioned it, the backline dive is going to be important. Curse Academy, and they want this so bad. So many times they have tried and just not made it into the LCS, but they are on the brink of it. This is the game. If they win this one, they're in. That's it.
And they love these cluster fights, and they might get themselves into the LCS off of that, because when people are grouped up, Hecarim heals himself off of everybody with the Spirit of Dreda.
A little bit odd to say, because MacNoon really should be liking that too, but as you mentioned, his equalizers just have been questionable this game, and it's also difficult the longer the game goes to try and scale. Some of these guys do fall off. Uhi's Zed, Nintendo X's Elise, and you see right there, Curse Academy, they are going to be the ones taking the uncontested dragon now. They grab themselves.
It's 2-2 in dragons, but the Baron buff still spinning on some members of Fusion, but you can see they can't utilize it against this three level up Keen. He's three levels up over MacNoon, but he's one level up over Hoohee, but he can still duel him. We saw it. Look at all these defensive stats.
MacNoon's getting a pretty good amount of damage on him, but look at how much he's got in the tank, and he's perfectly okay. That's just a scratch in the armor.
Those Baron buffed up minions doing a little bit of work, but there's the binding on Nien. Can they follow it? Doesn't look like it. They're too far.
Haunter, yeah. They're going to try to set up this bait again, but again, Keen, here he comes again. He's got the Black Shield on him. Jumps MacNoon. Nowhere to go, or is there? He's got the Equalizer on, but Keen with another legendary kill. Going for it. Bunny Fufu. Golden in there. St. Vicious, where did he go?
Ooh.
Keen, he might have checked too far forward. A double kill for Hoohee. Can they turn this fight? But here comes Haunter. Can they avenge it? Cop, he's locked up. I don't know if they're going anywhere with that one. Haunter taking down Gleam, and Haunter going down himself. Dien Tonso, and it is a 3-for-2 trade, this time in favor of Team Fusion.
A lot of things went very wrong there for Curse Academy, but very right for Fusion. Nien made the right idea of jumping in and getting into the part of the fight that had those frontliners that had gone too deep.
Yeah, this time just a little bit over the top there. And same Vicious, he doesn't look like he has tank stats. Just as soon as he jumps in, they collapse right on him and take him down. And then Keen, he thought he had backup, but that just didn't happen. Haunster taken off the back of that one. That's going to result in a turret for Team Fusion. 4-3 in turrets. It is 28 and a half minutes, and they're finally able to make use of that Baron buff. But here comes the pony up top.
Yeah, very close to his Randuin's Omen here. And all of that focus onto Mac Noon, you're going to see it here again. They get his flash, they blow the ghost for the extra damage, end up getting him with the ultimate. But then watch Nien. He gets out of the Morgana ulti by Valkyrieing over the wall. It's his best option to continue doing damage, because if he'd gone off to the left, wouldn't have happened. Cop comes in, and there's a cocoon by Nintendo that locks him up and stops his damage here from taking out anybody in this fight, and they're able to walk away during that. They pick up the Janna with the Maokai, but he trades himself for it.
Yeah.
Really good cocoon there by Nintendo, because that would have cost Nintendo's life as well as Gleaves and possibly the Intanso's.
Yeah, Nintendo has come up pretty big in that one, and they're starting to roll it a little bit together, but they've got to find more than just a couple of engages strung together to make that happen. The chaos is what they thrive on, but Curse Academy, as soon as everyone is grouped up, they've been taking the fight to him. 10-1, Keen may not have a perfect game on the books anymore, but he's still got quite a lot going for him and a massive level advantage over his opponents. Nintendude's locked up. Ooh, they're going to get the culling on. Nintendude has to tank this one for just a second. He can't get involved in this fight just yet. Baron is going to be up in 2 minutes now, but they're starting to look down this middle to see if they want to take towers.
Fanning off towards the Baron, like you said, not up, trying to get vision control of this river area. It's no man's land, and everybody's fighting for it, because these fights haven't really been on just one person's turf. It's still back and forth.
Yeah, Bunny Fufu waiting in the wings there. You see, he's been landing those bindings like nobody's business today. And he's got the distortion, so he gets his cooldowns up for the flash and ignite as well. And we talked about it. He got that very early Zhonya's Hourglass because he got the extra kills. And wait a minute, here comes Keen. Where's he going?
He's going bottom to deal with Mac Noon. But this guy has a Yomu's Ghostblade now. He's looking for just even more movement speed, even more damage. That's another spike for Hecarim.
And he's close to the
Randuin's. Because of how multiplicative it is.
Oh, here we go. Yes, he can. The fear is there. You can't escape from Keen. And that is going to be a pickup as soon as he wants to take it. Well, Mac Noon, you can't get away from that one. Hoohee, though, he might come back to this. Keen, they're going to trade in for Haunster here.
It's
everybody
just two,
for Fusion, though. Yeah, Keen could be popped. And that's Hoohee going to be able to take him down, getting the Rampage kill for himself. Haunster staying alive, but it's a double kill. Going over to Hoohee, finally grabbing two for one.
And they're not going to get anything for this except Saint running up there. This is actually better for Fusion. 2-for-1. It looked like it was just going to be a 1-for-0, but it lasts long enough. Mac Noon doesn't go down fast enough, and now they get to push this.
Yeah, he bought enough time for his team, and as a result, it looks a lot better right now for Fusion. They're able to chunk down this tower. The mini waves are starting to evaporate, though. Cop is chasing them off at Bunny, that ever-present threat. If they land a binding, they do. It's on the Intanso. Cop going to try to make something happen. This is a 2v3, though. Cop's going to get exhausted. Push back. Bunny is in a bad spot, but Gleam Glarmu goes down.
Saint
Vicious from the back is able to be in a dunk on. The Intanso answering back, and now Nintendo Dex is going out. Can Saint get the triple, though?
He's got EQ.
Taking his time, flag and drag up, force the flash. Nintendo Dex, it looks like he's gonna make it out with the tiniest of health bars.
Because Hoohee is coming around the side, and they're too low to deal with this, and that's gonna be Mac Noon as well. Keen, he's up, but what can he do? I don't know if he wants to take this fight. It's a 2-on-1.
Well, he might be able to get away from this one, but the death mark is on, using his defensive ult to try to get away, and he does. Oh boy. Keen is starting to show a couple cracks in the armor, but he's still pretty big.
This is just the edge of a knife here, the pinhead between these two teams. Only 1,000 gold, almost 2,000 between them at 32 minutes. Curse Academy, if they take this game, they are in the LCS. And if Fusion take this game, they even up this series after all that pressure. Bunny comes in with the ultimate, but it is disengaged by Gleave Glarbu immediately. He does trade his life for it, but then it's just a back and forth brawl. Bunny gets out. Cop gets blown up as he runs in. And Saint Vicious is there to just try and clean up, but he isn't able to get that last kill.
Yeah, Hoohee and Fusion in general have just been doing a good job of collapsing when their team can buy time, even if they know they're going to die. Not just Mac Noon, of course. But yeah, really, really big ups to Fusion for recognizing this map presence that they've needed to have. Baron and Dragon both live right now. This game gets a little bit more interesting. It's so close. It's almost tied up. The gold difference is only about 2,000 at 33 minutes. That doesn't mean a whole lot. But Curse Academy are looking to grab something. He sees Nintendo Dex. Can he splat the spider? He's running right on towards him. And here comes St. Vicious. Oh, juked out. Who? He's there as well. And they just get away with nothing.
Gave him a way out there. Dragon is live. Baron is live. There's so many options on the field for these two teams. The team fight, though, is also another one. But the thing is, you want to fight around the objective. So if your team wins, you get it.
They can start to force down on the Dragon side. They definitely want to be able to take this next one. Two to two in Dragons.
Curse Academy spent all their wards on the top side of the map, and now they're heading towards the right side of the map.
Calling their bluff right now, Fusion. They're starting to group up towards this Baron Pit. They've given up a little bit of map control, but the wards are still out there. They're going to spot Huhi as he moves into this brush. Look at this cop soloing the dragon. This is smart right now. As long as they don't take the fight, they're able to do it, and he's going to pick it up. That's three dragons now to two, and Curse Academy grabbed that little edge.
Yep, didn't expect the solo there. Fusion had no vision control of that dragon. It was swept out. They went up to the Baron, warded it up, so they had that safety precaution, and then they went back to the dragon with just cop and kept four people in the middle to stop the push as a retaliation.
It's in Curse Academy's advantage right now to just try and keep stalling this one out. They've got a decent-sized minion wave bot. It's going to keep growing. There's really nothing happening up top. And at this Baron, the dance will continue, but both partners looking a little shy.
Keen hitting that level 18, the only level 18 person in the game. He wants to push that a little bit.
Take a fight, Keen. Ooh, buddy. Can't quite catch him. Oh, he slowed down for just a second.
That's okay.
He's perfectly fine. Mac Noon going to hit in the face with a bit of light.
Oh.
Who he looking for a chase on Bunny now, but they retreat so fast when they haven't been aggroed. Minion waves get dissipated down bot. They're pinging out the Baron. They want to go back to the Tango. Curse Academy looks like they are ready to answer.
Back to the Baron, but no, they stay in the bush.
Ooh, rush
for the pick.
Answer. Oh, and it's all revealed. Hero Sapling. Cop gets his calling on Mac Noon, taking pretty low on that one, but he can still get involved if he wants to. He has both his teleport and his equalizer available. Cop and Bunny moving up to try and clear some vision out. Saint covering for them. Damage control right now here. Keen up the middle. Fusion, everybody here is in the mid threatening here, but it's a difficult task to take down this inhibitor shell turret if they want to. They're going to try and call the bluff. There is a wave pushing against Curse Academy in the top lane. Gotta be a touch-and-go thing. Mac Noon, they were looking for him right there. Actually, St. Vicious dashing in. He finds Huey. They're going to try to jump onto him, but he's shadow-stepping away, moving and dodging and weaving. Who's going to go down first? It looks like it might be Huey, but he's got himself a Guardian Angel, so it won't be just yet. Hanser now going to go in, and he gets blown up by Nien Tanso. They turn about. Huey doesn't go down. Double kill for Nien. Can he get the triple? Keen's got nowhere to go. Yes, he can. Nien Tanso with the triple kill.
It's 3-0, and they're going to start pushing this and most likely get an inhibitor.
They can take it right now. It's only Saint and Bunny defending. They don't really have the pushing power between them. There's minions on the top. They can take this in him. They can rotate up to mid. They can rotate to Baron. They have so many options right now, Zyrene.
And it looks like they have a minion wave. There's 30 seconds on Keen, 10 on Hanser.
This is crazy. They're going to try to end this here, at least take out a tower. Bunny, he's low. He's got his Zhonya's on. They have to back away from the lasers, or do they? Bunny's going to just burn his flash to escape. Oh! Who he shut down. Stayed a little too long.
He went too far for that kill. Slow down. Those turrets slow you now.
They do?
Yeah.
Lasers hurt and slow.
The lasers slow you. BTW.
FYI.
Yeah.
Leap Glarbu. Yen. Nintendo. All a little bit low here, but Hanser doesn't quite have enough damage with his sapling. Mac Noon just takes it. And actually, look at this. Curse Academy all heading beeline right now for this Baron. They're realizing this might be the time to take it, so a bit of the greed of Fusion is not going to net them much of anything here, but Curse Academy starting this one off. They don't quite have that much damage, but here comes Keen. He's the one that they needed, the hero that they deserve.
Mac Noon,
can he make something happen on this one? They know the Baron is happening. They're clearing it away. Everyone's got to start rushing back to this, but Cop has joined the fray now. Curse Academy, all five members in the pit. This Baron is going down. The Equalizer not going to burn, and it gets picked up. This time it's Hanser who takes it. St. Vicious. That looked close.
He's like, just burst it. Just burst it.
I don't care who takes it, guys.
Well, as long as it's not Mac Noon, he's happy.
Exactly. That one didn't go over. So Curse Academy picks that Baron up. They have to start pushing back, though. They have no inhibitor in the middle, so that would probably be the wise place to start pushing waves. Looks like they've already gone ahead on it, but they lose a tower down bot and all of that to just the minions.
Off a very devastating team fight in the middle, losing their inhibitor, they get the Baron buff, and they are back in this game. And the fact that Huhi overextended. There's no way they could contest that afterwards on Fusion's side.
Definitely breathing some life into this Curse Academy team right now, but Fusion looking to set up this bait. They're trying to do exactly what Curse Academy tried to do to them right before the last dragon. They could grab it in a couple of minutes, but they don't really have the quite right timer there. Still a few minutes away.
Look at that, the Baron buffed up minions coming in.
Versus the super minions.
Yeah, the Baron buffed up minions win.
Not if there's a team there.
Well, in order to be Baron buffed up, there's a team nearby.
That's true.
The thing
but
is,
they backed away.
The damage reduction on the melee minions is really high. So when they clash with other minions, they usually school them, and then they start ganging up on the big one.
It's a pretty solid wave in this top side here, and you can see MacNoon going to clear that one away. But that's going to mean there's going to be one less person here to deal with this mid. Without an inhibitor, you'd think they'd be the ones being sieged against or having to push back, but they've got a couple minions of their own. That Baron buff, as you mentioned, making them really big here, and they can keep this one going for a little while. MacNoon now coming around, trying to get the flank on, the shield on the tower, keeping it strong for now, and that threat alone will be enough to deter Curse Academy for the moment. Coming back in for round two. MacNoon has to keep playing.
It's funny, because they don't really have ranged wave clear on the side of Curse Academy. They do have some in the Intanso, and MacNoon, and also Huhi has some safe wave clear. But Curse Academy is mostly melee. They can throw like a sapling, but
they have
it's really rough.
They have a lot of all in, but it's difficult to do under the second tier turret, especially with MacNoon able to push them back here and the threat of Huhi just popping somebody. They're trying to keep Cobb safe in the backline. Bunny Fufu right with them. There we go.
15 on Dragon. Curse Academy backing off, getting control of this area. They haven't swept it. They haven't gotten rid of the pink wards that are over there. But here's the thing, is they're still super minions, and they're just kind of like pushing and pulling in this mid lane between the super minions and the Baron buffed up minions.
Well, they have to have at least one person there, as you mentioned, but look at this, waiting in that brush.
Spotted
in the ward, yeah. Not going to be baited out this time. Fusion backing away. If this dragon does get started, it could be a big toss-up now, but Fusion could take the opportunity to start shoving something in here. A big wave down bottom also for Curse Academy, so they might want to wait this one out for just a minute, but they're Baron buffed. It's got a timer on it. Oh, this dragon's going quick.
Warded up, and it is taken.
Here we go. They're going to start roaming down to this bottom side. Try to move on the minions. Here we go. Saint Vicious leading the charge, making those minions a little bit tankier for the time being. MacNoon trying to clear them away, but everyone from Curse Academy is here. Fusion joining the fray. They're going to rush down to the turret, try to get the all in if they can. Huhi's actually locked up for just a second, and here we go. He didn't even get out of the binding before they took the tower down.
Yeah, and Keen showing some restraint that time. He didn't dive straight in. You can see Curse Academy, they're trying to play it a little bit safer until they know that they have the engage available to him. And now he's just big.
He's not just big, he's fast. Keen marching out the gate so quickly there, and they just didn't even miss him at that point. Clearing away the minions himself with the greatest of ease. And it's so hard to push in on this Curse Academy squad. Even when they managed to take down two or three of their members, Fusion's having a hard time with the siege.
He's got himself the extra tenacity there from the Elixir of Iron. And now Keen, he wants to break that line. That's his big goal is just to do that. Look at that, he backs.
I feel like I'm watching a replay.
Just to run back through the lane. I don't even know if he bought anything. He just wanted to run back through the lane.
Game's all about having fun, man. Saint Vicious clearing out that Scuttle Crab.
Yeah, he didn't buy anything. He just wanted to run back through the lane and have full mana. It makes sense, I guess.
You got to use those home guards at some point.
Yeah, well, he's getting his
mileage. Exercise,
oh my god,
for
he's
real.
Getting his money's worth on those.
How many horsepower does he have?
He bought those early too. That's his first buy, is those home guard boots.
Yeah, Saint, by the way, talk about him a little bit for a second. He's got a little bit more damage mixed in, that black cleaver.
Yeah.
It's gonna help him a bit more. He has been evaporating a lot in these fights, going pretty quickly, but he's only gone down three times, so
yeah,
it hasn't been too worse for the wear.
And the black cleaver on top of the fact that Jarvan shreds percent armor anyway with the Dragon Strike. He's going to set up Keen for even more damage.
And over on the side of Curse Academy right now, they are just kind of trying to move them all over the map. Fusion trying to respond wherever they can, but the waves are just starting to push against them, and the inhibitor's back up, so they really don't have too much to extend the siege with.
Curse Academy seem fine with waiting this out and waiting for the perfect engage, the perfect team fight, or catching somebody, because they are one dragon away from five dragons.
Yeah, they...
And possibly the LCS.
That's quite a lot bigger, actually, but if they can grab that other dragon, it might help them accomplish the other goal. Baron is a minute and a half away here, though.
Ooh, almost hit Nian Tonso there.
Now Cop...
When's it going to happen?
St. Vicious trying to get in, test the waters, but Fusion, they are a little bit cautious here.
One positional error, getting hit by a binding, getting hit by a flag and drag, is going to cost you your life and possibly the game for your team. Keen, he's looking for that engage. Haunter's looking for the flash engage. All these summoner spells are up. Glebe, he's going to have to disengage it when it comes in on him and disengage it correctly.
Everything on the line here. As you mentioned, a knife's edge for this game. Curse Academy win this one. They win out. They go through to the LCS. Fusion, if they can take this, keep their hopes alive. The inhibitor was cracked first for Curse Academy, or on Curse Academy's side, but Fusion, they haven't really been able to take much since then. They have a couple inner turrets remaining, but Curse Academy, again, as you mentioned, they're perfectly happy to scale this into late game.
This is farm. This is prep. This is prep for that one fight. Is the calm before the storm. That one dragon, Fusion have to contest it. Curse Academy won it. That would give them this game very easily. Baron up in 15 seconds. It's not on Fusion's radar at the moment. They have to get there and ward it up so that it isn't an option. Bot lane is pushing, and Haunter has to answer. He has the teleport, but there's also a naked inhibitor in mid.
Yeah, there's some farm down bottom that Haunter has to go ahead and clear away, so they won't be able to take this fight just yet. But Cop and Keen are frontlining this one just fine. That vision war happening here. Fusion just trying to make sure no one can sneak a Baron at this point. It becomes an incredibly dangerous thing to do. Dragon now 2 minutes away. Baron is live. The map starts to get a little bit more lively as we get into the 45th minute of play.
Baron is live. Keen taking some poking. Slow.
Slow. Oh, they caught back in though. Do they want to go in on it? I don't think so. Cop is just going to send a calling his
HP.
Way.
Half HP off of that for Mac Noon, and they have no way to heal him besides using a Mikhail's Crucible, and they don't want to do that. So he's going to back. He has Teleport available to him, though. And here's the thing, is this is a setup, and Curse Academy already have the inside route to Barret.
Going to just clear away.
Crab control.
They do have crab control as well. That's a very important thing to have. Don't have total vision control of that area. There is one outside of their range of sight, but Fusion, not daunted, pushing up here. They have a wave in the bottom, unassisted, a one in the top as well. That is going to have to be dealt with sooner or later, but Curse Academy, if they can't turn a fight, all of that won't matter.
These bindings, so follow-ups, these ultimates.
Bunny is just...
Who are they used on? Who do they hit?
Bunny is so patient with this right now, waiting to see if he can get the catch. If they can, St. Vicious and Keen can just jump on him. Haunts are now clearing these waves away. They did take quite a lot of damage on that tower, but that's what the towers are there for. Prevent the minions from getting all the way into the base, but they've got to be careful. This bottom side's still undefended, and there's a lot of minions marching.
It's undefended. Dragon, 20 seconds.
If they want to go, they have to go now. Keen, he's taking his time actually trying to clear out the mid cops here as well, but they're not answering. They're just trusting their minion waves to fend off along with this tower on the bottom. It becomes such a tense moment here. St. Vicious did back. He's not quite as fast as Keen, but he's able to walk on two legs. And they'll be moving on forward, looking for that fateful dragon fight. It's now live. Might get soloed here by Nian.
Here's the thing though, is Curse Academy have more options. Because Fusion have to take this dragon away from Curse Academy, that allows Curse Academy to put pressure on the Baron, and that's gonna be Nian Tonson picking up a very crucial dragon for them.
Yeah, he really needed that one. It's going to go over, and they're just trying to bait out this, but they don't realize that there is that ward there spotting them, and now they do. The jig is up, and Curse Academy just can't answer for that dragon right there, so Fusion able to get one critical to their mission.
Hit on Hui.
Nobody's following up available. The culling is going to land.
Here goes Keen.
Here comes Keen. He wants to start the fight, getting a little bit trigger happy right now. Nian Tonson, they jumped on him, but the equalizer going to connect. Hui burning down. He's going to take down Keen before he goes, though. And that is the Zanya's Hourglass for Bunny Fufu Nintendo Dex. Hui, he's going down. Everything's going haywire. It's a 2-for-2 double kill going over to Cop. Looking for more. Saint Vicious going to manage to take down Nintendo Dex. And it is a 2-for-3. Not the decisive fight, but they do manage to get themselves an edge.
At the same time, though, both AD carries up. They could go straight for this middle inhibitor, but it's not really that worth for a trade on Baron, but it's what they'd be able to get at this point in the game. Nian Tonson completely zoned out of that fight by Haunter, gives up his life for it, but doesn't even pop his GA. Nian is still standing.
Yeah, and this is why it's so dangerous. He effectively has a second lease there now. Everyone from Curse Academy a little bit low, but Cop trying to back away. Glebe doing a great job zoning them up so they don't go ahead and try to trade the objectives. As you said, they could have gotten it, but it wouldn't have been that great of a trade. Instead, they scare off Curse Academy, and Curse Academy has their bluff called.
This fight was just very sloppy from a lot of people here. St. Vicious didn't even get in. Glebe stopped him. Perfect play by him. Keen knocked back. Has to re-engage, trying to get to Nian Tonso, but disengages because Nian gets off to the side. Hanser tries to get to him desperately, and then Glebe is there to attend and still provide some backup to the main fusion line, which was just a big cluster, again, where they want to fight. And St. Vicious is causing it on top of multiple members and setting the team up for success.
Absolutely. Now, Curse Academy, they're still in the lead here. They still have the chance to try and pressure this Baron. Pinging it out, they might want to just start rushing it right now. Immediately after taking the Scuttle Crab, they start this one off. A snap judgment, and Bunny Fufu trying to zone at the team, but this is revealed right now. They're going to pop a couple of wards all around the way. The Baron is going low. They're zoning off Glebe. Excellent
2000.
Call here. Teleport in for MacNoon. I don't think they can stop this one, and that's taken down by Kopp.
Hit
now
by
they're jumping onto MacNoon. He's got to go Zhonya's, and he just dodges away with his Flash. Keen in hot pursuit. MacNoon separated from the team. He's down, that's Cop, and they grab one, and the Baron looking for Nian Tonso.
75-second death timer. They're looking for Nian. They can't get to him. He's too slippery.
Just a little bit, but they've got a massive wave down bottom. They can start this one off. They have
and
a number advantage.
Up.
They have the Baron. Keen just taking a swipe at the minions along the way. Nian's still not out of the woods. He's out of the forest, but here comes St. Vicious forcing the Valkyrie. Nintendude is there. They're zoning him off. Couple of saplings tossed their way, and this is a big minion wave right now. They've got to be able to push this one in with that.
And with the damage that they have, they'll most likely crack the base, but Cop has to be the one to get in on this turret. They're zoning him off, and he finally finds it.
He's going to be able to pick it. They're going to go for more, though. Again, the Valk, they're just forcing Nian to not really get involved in these fights. Inhibitor in the bottom side now, going over to Curse Academy, and they just started to pull ahead of Fusion here.
And it finally actually worked out in their favor that they had that gigantic minion wave that we were talking about up against their bottom turret on their inhibitor for Curse Academy. They just left it there. And then it started to stack up actually against Fusion. And then it became this gigantic ball of death that they baroned up.
Planned all along.
Don't know about that, but it worked out.
In any case, Curse Academy find themselves with an inhibitor here. There is a naked one in the middle,
man,
that Fusion want to be able to take down, but it's so difficult to take these fights.
MacNoon has that one KDA this game and only three items in his inventory. Four items on Hanser. He is very far behind in terms of what he is contributing to these fights. His equalizers have not been on point at all. Also, speaking about late game effectiveness, Nintendude on that Elise, it's kind of the repeat. You do well throughout the game, but then that Elise later on, in terms of effectiveness versus what Jarvan can bring, it pales in comparison. You have to pick people, but Curse Academy are not separating.
Not at all. They're trying to keep it all together now, and they tried to have
Nian
to make
one.
Something happen, but he's having to come back and defend this one. Towers are falling so quick, they just burst on through them. They don't need Siege when they've got damage like that. Another inhibitor, and they're going to get this one for free unless Fusion can chase him down. A calling parting shot for Cop. Nian Tonso having to tank it. Curse Academy just rolling at 52 minutes.
Opposite side inhibitors down. Empowered Recall, they get to go back to base very quickly and then come straight out and keep applying the pressure. They're going to go straight down this mid lane, dragging up in 1 minute, and they have these inhibitors for much longer than that, as well as a Baron.
Dire times right now for Fusion. They need this win to stay alive, for their LCS hopes to stay alive, to make it into that spring split season. But Curse Academy, they're on the cusp of this right now. It's 51 minutes in. These games are long, but this has been nonstop back and forth. The mind games have been intense here. It's 40 seconds on this dragon. They have to contest it, but they have no inhibitors in the top and bottom, as you said. How can they keep this going?
Here's the thing. Is Curse Academy, they have control of this area. They just have to stand here and let the super minions come into the base and do the work for them from opposite sides. They can stand there, or they can do the dragon. Fusion have to contest it, or else they give up a fifth dragon, or they have to go back to the base at like the same time. They have to do too many things at once.
But all the same, Curse Academy is revealing themselves, trying to put more pressure on this middle and just keep control of it. They can go back and take the dragon whenever they want. It's just about to spawn. But Fusion seem to be a little confined to this middle lane right now. Saint Fish is looking around the side, see if he can find something.
Super minions.
Waves are pushing.
Clashing against Nexus turrets.
They just need to buy time. Oh, they separated Magnoon. He's going to throw down the Equalizer. He goes Zhonya's. Meanwhile, in the back, Huhi causing some havoc, but Cobb is not having any of it. And they pop his Guardian Angel, keeping on going. Saint Fish is picking the kill. Huhi going down.
Nien's Magnoon, the big one,
he's
though.
Gone. Keen, he's in the front. They're going to push him back. Nien Tanso has not able to get into this fight. He just can't do it. And the turret's going down. They're on the Nexus right now, teleporting in. Hanser, he's making it happen. They could take the game
he's
right here.
Up.
He jumps onto the end. Tanso, they pop it. And that's going to be it. That's going to be Curse Academy into the LCS for the 2014 Spring Split.
Smiles all around on their faces. Such a relief. And Saint Vicious, everybody, he's back in the League of Legends Championship Series.
You just see the joy there on that team, the Curse Academy support squad. It's the whole Curse organization support squad. Taking game one, taking game two very convincingly, forcing Fusion to come in and adapt to their style and adapt to their support squad and what they've thrown at them. Fusion take a game, throw a wrench in the plan, and then they come back by adjusting their strategy back to what it was before. Hard engage. Get Nien out of the fight. And Keen helps them with a Hecarim mid.
He makes it happen, and he picks it all the time into those AD mids. He made such a play. He got so far ahead. Magnoon actually looked like he was doing pretty good, talking about somebody who had some trouble a little bit earlier, but he just fell off. They fell off in scaling, and you can hear the crowd cheering for him now, walking out on stage. And what a play they had all around. Curse Academy just taking that fight where they needed to, when they needed to, and they didn't take any unnecessary risks to get there.
Yeah, and the fact they played it slow, controlled, put them in that catch 22. Fight us or we get Dragon. They catch Magnoon and they win the game off of that.
Yeah, what a massive success it has been. And, you know, they had a little bit of a stumbling block. There was Fusion adapting. They looked great.